There's been a predominance in the African American community. Is there a comprehension as to why that is?
Yes, there is, Will. And it's, as is all situations associated with the disparities of health in minorities, particularly the African American community.
I have a couple of answers on that, because we're working very hard on the African American community with respect to what's going on, because it's not good. I don't like it.
And it's really terrible, because it's just one of the failings of our society, is that African Americans have a disproportionate prevalence and incidence of the very comorbid conditions that put you at high risk.
Hypertension, asthma,
obesity, diabetes. If you get infected, you're going to have a poor outcome. When it's all over, is to focus a bright shining light on what disparities of health mean.
And we're actively engaging on the problem of increased impacts. This is a real problem, and it's showing up very strongly in our data on the African American community. And we're doing everything in our power to address this challenge. It's a tremendous challenge. It's terrible. And provide support to African American citizens of this country who are going through a lot, but it's been disproportional. They're getting hit very, very hard. In fact, while we have Tony here, I'd like to maybe have you come up and address that one, and then I'll continue. But if you could address that, it would be great, Tony, please.
Yes, thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.
We have a particularly difficult problem of an exacerbation of a health disparity. We've known literally forever that diseases like diabetes, hypertension, obesity, and asthma are disproportionately afflicting the minority populations, particularly the African Americans. Unfortunately, when you look at the predisposing conditions that lead to a bad outcome with coronavirus, the things that get people into ICUs that require intubation and often lead to death, they are just those very comorbidities that are unfortunately disproportionately prevalent in the African American population. So we're very concerned about that. It's very sad. It's nothing we can do about it right now except to try and give them the best possible care to avoid those complications. About sometimes when you're in the middle of a crisis like we are now with the coronavirus, it really does have ultimately shine a very bright light on some of the real weaknesses and foibles in our society. And as some of you know, the greater proportion of my professional career has been defined by HIV/AIDS. And if you go back then, during that period of time when there was extraordinary stigma, particularly against the gay community, and it was only when the world realized how the gay community responded to this outbreak with incredible courage and dignity and strength and activism, that I think that really changed some of the stigma against the gay community, very much so. I see a similarity here because health disparities have always existed for the African American community. But here again, with the crisis, how it's shining a bright light on how unacceptable that is. Because yet again, when you have a situation like the coronavirus, they are suffering disproportionately. As Dr. Berg said correctly, it's not that they're getting infected more often, is that when they do get infected, their underlying medical conditions, the diabetes, the hypertension, the obesity, the asthma, those are the kind of things that wind them up in the ICU and ultimately give them a higher death rate. So when all this is over, and as we've said, it will end, we will get over coronavirus, but there will still be health disparities, which we really do need to address in the African American community.